Hello everyone, I'm Ramesh Raskar, professor here at MIT, and I'm so excited to see how our AI Venture Studio course is coming along.
We start with the technology. We're very deep. We understand it well. And we say, I built a technology. Make sure to start with the market. I couldn't emphasize this more. Like I continue to make this mistake sometimes, but because technology excites me. I mean, that's frankly true, but if you don't start with the market, you'll just, you'll build something that nobody will use.
Robotics or elderly care, is it going to chop vegetables for me? Is it going to, clean the house? Is it going to be something which can talk?
This is not a typical entrepreneurship class. We are not teaching the mechanism of entrepreneurship. What we're really teaching is how should you aim your cannon? How should you choose your venture thesis so that when you get going, you'll be in the right direction?
It's been such an incredible opportunity to learn more about different opportunities in artificial intelligence, as well as how to turn that opportunity into an actual profitable business. They bring in incredible speakers. I've been extremely impressed by all the people that they've brought in so far. And I think it's such a great opportunity to try and launch this idea and turn it into reality.
I think the Uber of AI or the Google of this moment is going to be two people who didn't know each other before this class but met and used this moment as an opportunity to build something epic.
We have a very rigorous process which we call spot probe method, where students take their initial venture thesis and then compare it against what's out there in the real world to see what could really be an enduring venture.
I'm excited to be a part of this class. I'm going to be helping with the spot probe methodology and getting people through this extremely aggressive schedule that we have to get to AI ventures at the end.
We've had more socials than we've had classes. For every class, we have like 1.5 socials. It's a place where people can informally meet some of our guest speakers.
I do think that robotics is an important area of work, not just for commercial, but I think also for research. In many ways, I think the current work around LLM is quite ungrounded, both in terms of sensing as well as in actuation.
Hi, my name is Milo Werner. I'm a general partner at The Engine. We love the MIT AI Venture Studio class. It just produces amazing students building amazing companies that are going to change the way we live our lives, and we're thrilled to be able to be a part of the class.
This is a unique moment in academia. It's very important to be at the boundary between translation between academia and industry. I have been very fortunate to have started an AI team at Facebook and Google and Apple, also running a lot of my own venture companies, running a venture fund. And what I've realized over time is that the traditional way of encouraging students to create their ventures is kind of broken. It's kind of a random walk approach. And that's why you hear the statistics about only 10% of startups survive. And this is very unfair to the students. 90% of them are going to fail. And I think we have a completely new way to encourage students to do a translation of some other work they might be doing on campus.
If you're a judge and you know it, please stand up. This is an incredible range of talent. And there are a lot of funders here that are gonna fund a bunch of these companies. There are a lot of thought leaders, a lot of product leaders, a lot of serial entrepreneurs, a lot of ridiculously successful people.
We have some of the most talented people across MIT and some other schools like Harvard taking this class. To take the class, you had to test in and show your coding skills. We took a portion of those who applied, and we're building great ventures. And there are a lot of venture studios. We want to be the best, and we want to learn from the best of what's out there. We don't want to have to reinvent the wheel. We don't want to experiment a lot. We want to take a little bit from here and there, so we welcome stakeholders to help inform us on that. Our formula is simple. Every Thursday, 10 to noon, fall semester, spring semester. Every semester, we have a demo day, December and in April, and we have some of the best judges coming. We want this demo day to be legendary. That's where companies get discovered, get support. We want to be known as a place for great AI ventures that can have impact.
You also noticed community was up there as the third point, because our third pillar is to have a community-first approach, because we believe that learning from others, seeing examples of successful journeys, or even collaborating on goals together is a way for people to get stuff done.
We have this showcase happening right behind us in the Media Lab. It was just great to see how many judges there were.
What stuck out to me were some of the AI-assisted healthcare solutions.
My name is Leroy Sivanda, and along with Javi and Asfar, we have over 15 years of product experience. We're also a highly technical team. We're all doing dual masters in computer science and integrated design and management here at MIT. But to understand the problem we're trying to solve, let's take a look at these three products and what do they have in common.
I really like how you recognize that care for these people is a community-based problem. So I would say keep pushing on that, the connectivity and helping people. My name is actually Susan, and you nailed the demographics, so awesome job.
Thank you so much.
One of the things you look for in an entrepreneur is super high energy and very coachable.
You have a unique opportunity right here, right now. The largest AI engineering talent density in the entire world is right across the street, right here at CSAIL. The only other contender for that is Stanford. At Stanford, a massive fraction of that talent gets sucked into OpenAI and Google, and so the talent supply demand gap is actually in your favor right here more than anywhere else on the planet.
Seeing how AI lives in our daily lives and can be applied in service industries like restaurants, and those are hard, complex problems, and I think some really good questions came up. The other thing I'm thinking is that teams are thinking about building a strong moat. So, you know, I think even just asking that fundamental question is super important.
Buckle up, the best is ahead.